There are pens that go really broad, some really fine, but most users tend to go somewhere in the middle. However, when it comes to extra fine nibs, I think it's an intentional choice, as users have specific goals in mind. In this video, I would go through some of the reasons why a fountain pen user would like to add an extra fine nib to their collection. To start off, the tuning of an extra fine nibs required an extra level of care to the tipping material and the ink flow. To dry, and the instrument is pretty much unusable. To wet, and it will not create the hairline finesse that users look for from these nibs. Because of that, users need to understand how their instruments perform and to go with their pace instead of making the instruments follow you. There is a certain rhythm to each pen, and it's the writer's task to adjust accordingly. At first, this might seem like a lot of work for a pen, but once you get the pace down, the writing instruments will become an extension of yourself, and it will let your thought flow on the page effortlessly. Extra fine lines give users less room for error with the way they form the letter shape, and each stroke does make or break the writing experience, but in a way, that's a really good thing. The thicker lines create from a medium or a broad nib do cover up the misshaping of the letters from time to time, and it's a reason why calligraphers tend to use finer nibs for their practice. The nibs will tell you whenever you misalign the tines on the page with a minor scratch, or skip when you accidentally roll the nib along the way, or it will bite down on the page whenever you use too much pressure. This is a good way to listen to the instrument and adjust accordingly to achieve the best writing you could possibly create with the use of extra fine nibs. After the writing session, when you look back at the writing you have created, the flaws in your handwriting will show, and it will be a good revision exercise to look back at these previous results to work on the next time you pick up a writing instrument. Due to the limited amount of ink flow, these extra fine nibs can work well with inexpensive paper, as they don't bleed through the other side or feather as much as a wetter writer should. It's a good idea to carry these on a regular basis to the workplace if you have nothing but photocopy paper to write with, or notebooks that are not intended for fountain pen users. However, these pens combined with finer paper such as Rhodia, or in the writing sample here, Tomoe River, the fine lines of the writing instruments really shine through. It will not bite and grab on the page as often, and the color of the ink of your choice could pop even just with a little hairline. There is a satisfying feeling when I look back at my own writing with little nuances from the little sparks of sheen that you couldn't really see from afar, especially when these cameras can never do them justice. I hope through this video, I could somewhat convince you to add an extra fine nib to your fountain pen collection, even though your thoughts on them might differ. Please let me know what you think down in the comment section below. Do you prefer finer or broader nibs for everyday writing or for your long writing session? What's your thought on extra fine nibs? If you enjoy the content and don't want to miss future updates and video releases, please click subscribe and the bell icon to let YouTube notify you with my future releases. Also, I will be posting regular fountain pen related content that you might be interested in on the Instagram page, so you might want to check that one out as well. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.